Ladies and gentlemen, I'm really pleased to be here, and I'm grateful to the organizers to inviting me. Of course, I'm also part of Plastis project, but also they gave me the possibility to present this lecture here. this title, we are two authors. It looks like Pavol Alexy is my PhD student because I am presenting and he's the first place, but it's not true. The reason why Pavel is here as a first is that he supplied the second part of my lecture. These are his results. And he's professor at Stuba University. That means we are both professors. It must be a very good lecture because two professors are participating on this lecture. Okay. Very short lecture outline, some introduction. I will deal with selected problems for BDPs. Just outline what is important from point of view, or second part, development of BDP blend within Plastic project. That means I am not going to cover everything. I'm just will concentrate on the substantial things which are necessary. Okay, concerning application, BDPs are mainly applied at the moment in special application, especially healthcare. Why? Because the main problem I see concerning the application for high volume application is the price. The price is simply if you are producing something like 10,000 tons or more, the price is important. If you are producing something in hundreds of kilograms, like for medicine, price is important, but not crucial. If it is that something can help me to keep up good health, and I don't care so much about the price. High volume applications. I think I will find. Okay, that. High volume applications. Packaging fibers, perhaps foams. There is concern processing. Very important because you have to apply the processing standard processing for very high volumes. Mechanical properties, of course, barrier properties might be interesting for concerning the packagings, water resistivity, of course, and as I said, the price. Well, let's see what are the properties. We need increase in toughness because usually the standard biodegradable plastics are based on polyesters, which usually are quite brittle. Second, proper processability, because thermal stability of these polyesters is usually not very, very good. Stability of properties during lifetime. I will tell a few words about this. Important is we need broad range of materials with different properties. That means what we need, something starting from polyethylene on the one hand side up to polystyrene. All this should be substituted by biodegradable plastics. This would be the goal for high volume. Even recently, we are thinking about substituting rubber by biodegradable rubber would be interesting. It is some kind of dream, but anyway, perhaps it will be sometimes reality. Because the last point is decrease of price. Well, brittleness, low deformability. If you compare the properties of PHB, polyhydroxy butyrate, for example, with polypropylene or polyethylene, we see that melting temperature is basically the same. TG, very close. Crystallinity, very close. Very high modulus, there is both materials rather stiff. Tensile strength, basically the same as polypropylene. The only difference here, elongation break. Polypropylene 400% before breaking. Polyhydroxy butyrate 5 or less. And this is the reason why polypropylene is tough and PHB is brittle. Polyethylene, the same problem. Tough polyethylene, flexible. PHB, brittle. But fortunately, if we want to compete with polyethylene, we have a number of possibilities what we can offer. We can avoid, we can allow decrease in modulus. We can allow decrease in tensile strength, no problem. Because we have still 40, if we drop down to 20, we are still above the polyethylene. If we drop this one by 10 times, we are still above the polyethylene. Yeah, and this is something certain advantage that we can, we have certain space to offer if we increase this crucial property, that means elongation break and toughness. Well, the two most important BDPs at the moment, PLA and PHB, low deformation break because high TG. PHB TG is about 4 up to 10, very close to room temperature. PLA is much above room temperature, about 60. Then that means we are basically below TG, and of course materials below TG, they are brittle. There is physical aging, I will say a few words about this, and thermal degradation during processing. These are the problems. Okay, physical aging, for example, of PHB, consists in this, that during a long time of storing, here it's a scale up to 3 months, 90 days. You can see the high Young's modulus, there's something like 1200 after thermal processing. Within 1 day it increases almost double, not double, but okay, by 1 gigapascal. And it is increasing further from 1 month to 3 months, still increase. On the contrary, the connectivity, this is deformation. Deformation at the beginning is something like 6-7%. Within few hours, it decreases down to 3%. And then decreases again below 2%, closing to 1%. Of course, tensile strength goes something like this. Then this is one problem that not the properties are not stable during the longer time. This physical aging, generally people say, okay, this is the reason for this physical aging is increasing crystallinity, secondary crystallization. But if we compare rise of modulus, goes like this, after 30 days, it is not yet stable. Crystallinity after 1 or 2 days is already on the edge. It doesn't, basically it doesn't change. This is something like contradictory. And but if we make DMTA measurement where this area under this peak corresponds to mobility of amorphous phase, it has nothing to do with crystalline phase, it's only amorphous phase, you can see that mobility of this amorphous phase is decreasing. Mobility of amorphous phase is decreasing, although crystallinity is not increasing. And the explanation like this, that we have crystallite, crystal here, in between the crystals are tie molecules. These tie molecules are, you see that it's very loose, and their mobility is quite high. If this crystallite is undergoes secondary crystallization, mainly these tie molecules are forming this additional crystallinity increase, which might be less than 1%, but you can see that even if there is less than 1% change in overall crystallinity, the shape of these tie molecules is changing very much, and these are much less mobile than before this aging. And this might be a reason, or this probably is a reason, why the materials here, the amorphous phase is flexible enough. Here, amorphous phase is already quite stiff. Okay, these are some possibilities what to do with increasing toughness. Of course, the obvious healing is blending with biodegradable flexible polymers like polyvinyl alcohol, PCL, Ecoflex, etc. We tried to mix it with polycaprolactone, and you can see that if we simply mix PCL with PHB, we can concerning the elongation break, we get nothing. It is a little bit increase if we enlarge this part here. You can see that it goes up. If we mix 50% of PCL, it goes up. Elongation goes up from something like 2% to perhaps 3% or 4%. It is basically nothing. Forget it. Why? Because it is not compatible. It is not compatible, and we need some compatibilization. We made compatibilization by cross-linking, that means formation of copolymers PCL PHB in situ. And you can see that here, after 30, 40, 50% of PHB of PCL to PHB, the elongation break increases. It is not something tremendous, but still, if you get more than 100% of elongation, it is already material starting to be quite flexible. It is quite interesting material. That means this is one possibility simply to mix the flexible polymers to these brittle polyesters. Of course, this problem is that PCL is still quite expensive, and that it doesn't. It is not very convenient to use it for increase of high volume applications. You can play also with plasticizers, and we have cross-linked blend PAB PCL plus triacetine. This is glycerol triacetate, and you can get, after adding 10 or 15% of this plasticizer, you can get more than 300% of elongation, which already really material very similar by the properties to polyethylene. Yeah, low thermal stability. We take PHB, you anneal it for, at the beginning, the molecular weight is 350,000. If we anneal it for 1 minute at 170 centigrades, it is drops down by 20% perhaps. If you anneal it for 10 minutes at 200 centigrade, what is processing temperature and processing time, the molecular weight drops down to more than 10 times. This is disastrous. If you add some plasticizers, triacetine, it doesn't have any consequence for molecular weight if compared with this. But if you use glycerol is initiating the further degradation, and you end up with something with 9,000 molecular weight, which is basically you hardly can name it as a polymer. It's already kind of oligomer. If we take annealing and we measure molecular weight on independence of time, you can see that even at 130 centigrades in solid state, the molecular weight decreases within 1 hour. It decreases from 350 down to 260 or 240. And if you take 190 or 180, in 180, within 10 minutes, decreases down to 60. It is terrible. It is simply non-acceptable from processing point of view. What you can do against this? We can use chain extenders. First point, that means there are chemicals which react, which is at least bifunctional, and they can react with moieties on after which are creating due to thermal degradation, then in carboxyl and the hydroxyls. If you have epoxy groups, they can react with carboxyl formed during thermal degradation. They can react with hydroxyl formed during thermal degradation and sew these remnants together. That means they should be able to keep the molecular weight at the same level as at the beginning. This is a jonquil produced by BASF based on epoxy. It's excellent for PLA, less efficient for PHB, but still effective for PHB. Another possibility is processing at low temperature. And what we did, we took PCL and processed it as a composite. We took PCL we put some plasticizer and processed, mixed in PHB as a powder at 120 centigrades. You could do it easily in extruder, and then if you want to produce just films, what you do, you increase the temperature in the dye at the last stage of the processing, when you are already forming this mixture to a certain shape. And this is a temperature, it lasts only 5 to 20 seconds, not more, and degradation is more or less negligible. By such a way, for thin extruded products, you can use this technology for avoiding the thermal degradation at all. You don't need any chain extender. You can have really quite good materials. We patented this, but unfortunately, no application yet from this point of view. Okay. Decrease of price, then what you can do, you can add some cheap additives like wood particles, starch, of course plasticized starch, or some plasticizer, which are also cheap, can decrease the price. Compatibilization, of course, is needed. Yeah, then now I'm coming to the second part of my question, that I mean developing a new BDPs blend within plastics case study. First, we have to deal with processing properties. Processing stability, this effect of shear rate, you can see here that for PLA, with increasing shear rate, that means how fast we are extruding, we can extrude slowly, we can extrude faster. And you get shape like this. These are typical shapes for non-Newtonian behavior. That means we can say that for PLA, it is more or less normal standard behavior. Of course, with increasing temperature, viscosity decreases, but it might be also just the effect of temperature, because if you increase temperature, of course, you have honey, you increase the temperature, honey flows much faster. The same for PLA, increased temperature, viscosity is lower. But for PHB, you can see that this is definitely not the effect of change of viscosity because of temperature. It is due to degradation, due to very fast degradation of PHB, depending on the temperature. If we increase temperature from 170 to 190, you see that the viscosity is decreasing to very low values, and such material is basically impossible to process. Impossible to process, it flows up out of the extruder if you have viscosity like this. The second point is effect of time. If we take polylactic acid, we have certain viscosity, and we anneal it for a certain time, then you can see that the viscosity is decreasing. This decrease is due to temperature, due to degradation of PLA, due to degradation of PHB. Of course, this degradation of PHB is much faster than degradation of PLA. This degradation also depends on temperature. There are different temperatures. The higher temperature, the lower melt viscosity. Now, if we take not this part, like absolute values of viscosity, but we make relative values of viscosity, that means we divide each of this point by first value of viscosity. That means this first value will be 1, relative viscosity will be 1, is relative viscosity, and you can see that temperature, the increase of temperature results in much faster decrease of relative viscosity. That means the effect of temperature is quite obvious, and for PHB, this decrease is much, much more pronounced than for PLA. And it is similar to this figure I already presented, decrease of molecular weight. You can see that this decrease is basically of the same shape as decrease of molecular weight. That means the decrease in viscosity, at least for PHB, is proportional to decrease in molecular weight. If we take just numbers, in this case we just randomly selected 8 minutes, After 8 minutes, we have decreased the viscosity for PLA. It is certain, not negligible, but for PHB is much higher. This decrease is much higher. Here, of course, the viscosity is already so low that further decrease in molecular weight is not so obvious. Then relative complex viscosity after 8 minutes of tests, depending on the moisture. This is also very important because main mechanism of decreasing of viscosity is hydrolysis. Of course, if it is dry material, it hydrolyzes much slower than if there is some moisture present. In here we have dried material with a certain percent of moisture, and these are two experiments basically for the same under same conditions, and you can see that the reproducibility is very good, and moisture is contributing to decrease of viscosity. That means to decrease of molecular weight very much. Here you can then see the relation between viscosity and molecular weight. It is something like this. It is quite clear that viscosity is the molecular weight is the main reason for changes of viscosity. Now, what could chain extenders could do? Here we have different amounts of chain extenders from 0.1 to 1%. These figures are without chain extender, just something for comparison. This is dried, this is non-dried, this is dried material. We keep it up after a certain time and follow the absolute viscosity. You can see that after addition of chain extender, we can even get different procedure. There will be increase in viscosity, that means increase in molecular weight. These chain extenders can affect the degradation by increasing the molecular weight. Something in this case we have only 0.3%. In this case, certain chains are broken, but the same amount of chains are sewed together. That means viscosity stays more or less constant. If we start with dried material, in this case, you can see that in all cases, this chain extender effect is consists in increasing of viscosity. That is quite, I would say, encouraging, because we can somehow influence on and to control the thermal degradation. In this case, we have process stability effect of PHB content, and you can see here that by increasing the PHB content, this viscosity is changing, but the changes are quite interesting, because this equation here indicates how viscosity is depending on this constant K, and if the constant K is zero, in this case viscosity wouldn't change at all. And you can see that the higher is this constant, the higher is extent of degradation because of decrease of molecular weight. And you can see here that, of course, if we have more fractional PHB, then we get quite high K. That means effect of degradation is quite pronounced. But at under certain conditions, we can get even lower K than for virgin PLA. And in this case, this is something what is surprising, first. Second, which also quite good, because in this case, addition of PHB should contribute to better thermal stability. Of course, you can explain this by this way, that if large amount of PHB is degrading, then there is viscosity, overall viscosity is decreasing. But if only small amount of PHB is degrading, this remnants of PHB can behave as chain extenders, because they can to certain effect to react with carboxyls and with hydroxyls. And if there is not too much PHB, this small amount of degraded PHB can effect is not very efficient, but still chain extenders to certain extent. Okay, mechanic properties, PLA. It undergoes to decrease changes in time. You can see here that tensile strength is increasing within something like 90 days or up to 1 year. The elongation of the braid decreases very much. This is storing. This is just something what is well known and is published, not by us, by other people. Yeah, now if we have plasticizer and modifier, this is mixture of PLA, PHB without anything, just simple mixture. You have some kind of yield behavior, you have tensile strength, you have very low elongation break, material is brittle. Unfortunately, you can do nothing. What would you expect? Of course, you are mixing two brittle materials. Would you expect to get tough, flexible material? Not at all. You wouldn't expect this, but you would be surprised. Because if we add plasticizer to this mixture PHB-PLA, you can see here that elongation break, sudden increase if we get 15% of PHB. You have plasticized material. If you plasticize PLA, not very big effect. If you plasticize PHB, no effect at all. If you plasticize the mixture of PHB and PLA, increase in elongation break from something like 5-3% to 350. This is something what you wouldn't expect. If we add just chain extender, this black, you see that no effect of chain extender. No effect of chain extender, only certain effect of this plasticizer. And if we add both chain extender and plasticizer, you can see that we get really elongation break quite high for all compositions of PHB with PLA, not for PLA itself. It is very little effect of plasticizer for PLA itself. But if you add small amount of PHB, you get already quite nice and rather tough material. Yeah, this effect of storing, this slide was presented already. But what happens with storing? I'm almost at the end of my lecture. What will storing do with the blend? This is PLA. This PLA, if we have blend PHB-PLA and plasticizer, you can see that there is basically very little effect of storing. There is, material properties are much more stable than just for PLA itself and uncomparable with version PHB. If you add chain extender, you can see that you get the same effect for elongation break, basically no storing effect. You can get increase in yield stress, which is important because yield stress is very important concerning the ultimate application properties of the material. And here's also tensile strength at break, which is influenced by the chain extenders. Okay, I came to the conclusions. Blends of PLA and PHB can be made flexible enough to be applied for packaging foils. And four-component blends consisting of two polymers, plasticizer and chain extender, provide a versatile property which can be adjusted in broad range just by rather small changes in composition of the blend. Well, I should present the people who are participating beside Pavel, Alexy and myself, Dušan Bakoš, sitting there, very, very good contributions to our research. And all these, except for Peter Bugaj, which is a scientist, a general scientist, all these were where have been the doctorants or PhD students of Pavel, Alexy, or mine. Thank you very much for your attention.